Okay. Well, it's just completely under hit. Stupid shot, really. But I'm close enough. Shouldn't have too many problems. Whoop. That was not a good shot either. But hoops aren't too difficult, as you can see. So I just want to give myself enough room to get pink to three back. Just stop the side of brown. Anywhere the side of brown's fine. Now, I would like pink quite close to three back. That's not a very good shot. Well, that's not bad actually. I prefer pink another yard, but that's the penult peel done. Just one peel to go now. I could have a go at peeling Rover going to white at two back now, but I think I'm just gonna try and pop it down close in front and try and peel it going to pink after two back. Well, that's just a terrible shot. I was using Barlows the other day. Maybe the effects of them haven't worn off yet. Not sure. White to somewhere where I have enough room to get it to pull back. Stop the side of brown, try and rush it into peeling position. That's not a very good stop shot at all actually. It's stupid. But I've got a nice rush on brown. And that's another terrible shot. I don't know, getting late in the day I suppose. I think I'll just, well, I could bring brown over with me. Like this. That's the other option. Just put brown northwest of three back. After the hoop. I didn't really want pink there. It's one place I didn't really want pink at all. But yeah, I don't really know where to put pink, this side or that side. Yeah. This is quite awkward actually. I wouldn't advise doing this. Actually, this is quite risky now. I'll put pink back through the hoop. Run three back. Try and get a rush on brown to in front of Rover. Like that, sort of. It's not too bad. So now I can have another go at peeling brown through Rover the roll. I really didn't want pink there. I really wanted it 3 yards closer this way, or even beside Rover if possible, but I could still have a realistic attempt at peeling this ball. I'm not good at these shots. See, they pull sometimes, they don't pull other times, but brown's okay. I think I'll just leave brown there until I get to Rover myself. Yeah. Pink's just going to be my penult pioneer. White isn't a very good pioneer at fullback at all, but got a rush on it, so it's alright. Now, I could go back down to brown, but I'm not going to bother. Brown's close, it's not in front of Rover, but it's close enough to Rover that I should be able to just tap it in front. Oh, that's not good. So, yeah. Just gonna Put white down towards rover. Preparation for the straight rover peel. I've had numerous opportunities to peel rover thus far, as you've noticed, but none of them have worked. So I'd rather like a rush out of the soup. Just make things a bit easier. A bit lucky there. Okay, odd angle. So just straight over peel. I want one opponent's ball at 3 yards from the south boundary, just in case I have to jump over anything and make the hoop. So I have a ball down there to hit. So I'll put pink down there. Hopefully it won't go out. No, that's quite close to the boundary. That's alright. I don't mind it. As long as it didn't go out. You have the other opponent's ball about level with rover. So that wasn't a very good shot. I should have hit that just a bit harder. But so put white just to the far side of the hoop, into the side, and try and get a great rush on brown. Like that. That's okay. So now just tap brown into peeling position. I'm going to do what's called an Irish peel. I'm going to put both balls through in the same shot. Like that. That's why I had white there. Green had gone 2 inches through, I would have been able to hit white. But green went nicely through anyway, doesn't matter too much. So I'll just take off behind the pink ball now. Well, at least to the pink ball. Hopefully not go out. Okay, I was very lucky there. I wasn't trying to get behind that. I was just trying to get up close to it. So I desperately didn't want to hit green off the lawn. Now just concentrate on getting a nice rush on brown to the pink. That's okay. So just pick them out. There you go, triple peel. And I feel completely stupid now. Played an entire break, the camera stuck to my head. What an idiot. Stay tuned for the 1st-person SXP. And probably the 1st-person various other things as well. So that's just me. I'm a croquet geek, what can I say? Okay.